think of the audience in relation to your films? Are they more of a spectator or a participant in the action?
Your films have a very immersive quality. They kind of really surround you. Do you think of the spectator as, or as the audience member, as just a spectator or as a participant in some way?
For me, you are my partner. I do not think you are a participant, because you are just observing something. No.
No.
My biggest problem since the beginning, when I was watching the movies from my childhood, I had a feeling all of the studio films are looking at me like a kid, you know? Mm-hmm. They want to entertain me, and they want to tell me stories, and I'm not curious about this. And when I'm doing a movie, when I'm thinking about you, I believe you are entertaining. You are very intelligent. And I have to do my best for you, because I need your respect. I need your attention. And I cannot get if I don't do my best, you know? And this is a big difference. I have to do my best, because otherwise, you know, and this is how I think about you when I'm doing it. And I don't want to give to you that stupid handle there from the past. I want to give you a beautiful, homemade hand made.
You're
in a very familiar way, you know, and very personal way.
Yes, sir.
Do you participate in the opening of a film in Europe or in Hungary? Do you follow the distributor? Do you kind of lead him to certain cinema to play or to certain festival to play, or you just...
Are you involved in the release of your films, both, I guess, in terms of festivals and also in terms of the distribution around Europe or other places?
I can't do physically possible, you know. I'm going... Since February, I'm on the way, and I see my schedule at the end of December, and I don't want to tell you it's more than one. And I'm going always just if I have a special reason. I came to here because this man and this town is too close to me. And I said, okay, I have to come. But I came yesterday evening, and I leave tomorrow. And, you know, physically impossible to check every distribution. But in Hungary, my company distributor in this case, I knew what is happening with the movie. And as I see around the world, some good companies can do it, and I trust them. I'm not worried about this.
Thank you.
Yes, back there.
Yeah, since you yourself have said you're done with making movies, what advice would you give to the next generation of filmmakers? And also, what do you see your influence on a new generation as being, if you see any influence at all? What do you think it would be?
What advice would you give to emerging generation of filmmakers? And if your films have been influential, what do you think their influence has been?
First of all, my advice, don't be influenced by me.
Anything else?
You have to be free.
Okay.
You have to be yourself. You have to be brave. Brave. And you have to be more revolutionary than me. And have to say to me, let's go to the museum because you became too tired and old fashioned. And no, that's what I want. Please to be more stronger. Okay, guys. I never give you any advice. I do not want to educate you and teach you.
Thank you.
perhaps you'll welcome him to your film school.
Right. He has the same question in
There's a fascinating passage in Satan Tango that I've heard anyone talk about in reviews or interviews with you, and it's I see similar kind of passages in Damnation and other films about freedom and order and chaos. And it's the scene with the police captain, like Arimi Ash and Katrina are there and interviewing them and having this dialogue. And the police captain mentions Pericles and says there's this link. The thing that links these two things is passion. So this seems like a consistent kind of element in many of the films that's intriguing to me. Perhaps you can respond to maybe even how that is emphasized in the camera possibly too.
Question's really about a moment in Shots and Tango when the police interrogation is happening, and there's a discussion about freedom and order and chaos. And the viewer thinks that it's really it resonates through your work, this concern. And I guess the request is that you comment on that.
Susan is wrong. No, the whole movie is totally about honesty. Please do not pick up on one. You know, because if you the whole Shatan Tango is talking about the different point of views.
I'm not saying you that's know, the only meaning of the whole
yes,
show,
sure.
But
in a different point of views, it's collective, you know. And the whole movie is became one. Like in the two we host to. It's very difficult to say something about this. I can say, okay, this scene is talking about this, what you mentioned. But I cannot take it out, and I cannot say the whole movie is talking about this. It's just a part, like a problem in our life, but we have to solve somehow, if we are able. But some of the problems are there too, the time and the rain, and this goodness, you know, of course, everything, how we lose our freedom, how we have no dignity, how we are waiting for our fake prophets, how we are walking in the mad, you know, how difficult the life. This is together, and of course, this is just the dance. Thank you.
Sorry, just a few more. Question.
Yes.
You express some unhappiness with Hollywood, and I'm just wondering if that extends to the whole history of Hollywood filmmaking, or if you had any admiration for maybe Golden Age Hollywood films or anything like that.
Questions, you mentioned some things about contemporary Hollywood, your displeasure with it, but are there figures from Hollywood's past, the Golden Age, who interest you as filmmakers?
I'm not sure either. I liked it very much, the Hitchcock movies, but don't forget how they treated Hitchcock. Okay? I love Griffiths. Of course, I'm a big fan of Pasadena. And I can tell you some really nice things which it was made on the West Coast. But I really don't know what is the value. Maybe just a nice view. With a lot of bad taste in houses.
Yes, sir.
I'm just feeling still a little itchy about your comment about filmmakers, the real filmmakers always having contact with film that has sprockets. So many of the filmmakers that I care most about, you of course being among them, Godard, David Lynch, Vinterberg, Chris Marker, Lars von Trier, so many of these, in my mind, great filmmakers who I live with have done marvelous and important, I think, important work with video. And I even believe that if someone had said to you at some point, you cannot shoot film, here is a video camera, and you can only use this video camera, I'm quite convinced that you would have made a film that would be amazing. I don't think it's about the tool. I think it's about your mind.
No problem. Like I said, okay, do it. But don't call it film. You should call it video, or you should call it motion picture. Doesn't matter how you should
okay.
call it. We are just playing with the words.
Okay.
No, it's not. I'm just telling you what is the film, what was and what will be.
I understand.
And
you mean
do it. Use it. Use it. Use everything.
Yeah.
Use everything.
But
just
for many of us, we're not going to have the option for film. I can't even get Polaroid anymore for the back of my.
Yeah, head. That's also.
It's here it is.
Yeah.
Okay.
Bella, thank you so much for coming.